Hello, hello. Welcome back to my little corner on YouTube. It has definitely been a hot minute since my last video, but I am determined to be more consistent on YouTube this year, and I guess we'll see how that goes. But before we head into the main topic of this video, which you probably want to know more about, I thought I would give you a quick update on what's happened in my life, just for those who are interested. If you're not interested, then feel free to just skip later on in the video. But yeah, in the past year, I've graduated uni with a major in finance and computer science. I started a full-time position at a VC firm, and then currently I'm a product owner slash growth product manager at a large bank, just building out and ideating new features to go into the app. And then I've also moved out, which has been really, really fun, and it has been a really good experience. And lastly, I have also gained a bit of weight, which I am hoping to get rid of this year. So right now I do have work very soon, so I'll probably need to get ready and bring you along with that, but straight after, we'll get straight into the video.
Hours later.
All right, let's do this. How I made an app that low-key went viral.
I was just in the middle of editing when I realized that the video was kind of shit, so I'm deciding to redo this whole section. I've split up this section into four main parts. The first part is why I'm making this video. Second part is a bit of context, so what is the idea and how did I come up with the idea? The third section is results, and the last section is my future plans with the website. So the first section is why am I making this video? There's two main reasons why I decided to make this video. The first one is just my personal reasons. So I wanted to create this video sort of for my own memories to recap the project that I worked on back in 2020. It was a pretty big project for myself back then, and I really just wanted a keepsake so that I can look back on it and remember the efforts and results that I was able to achieve. And the second point why I'm making this video is to provide a repeatable framework for other people who make a website that can create some tangible results. It'll also look very good on your resume as well, just because there's results behind it and you are out of sort of thinking outside of the box to create something that will stand out from other candidates. So what is the idea and how did I come up with it? So the quiz is called True Asian Test, and it was based on my own childhood and personal experiences as a Southeast Asian. I basically created a fun and lighthearted quiz where users can go onto the website and read through a bunch of experiences or niche jokes that they might have had in their childhood or in their past, and at the end it calculates how many boxes you ticked and gives you a score and a funny message, and hopefully the quiz makes you laugh so that you send it to other people, and through that it's spread. So I came up with the idea, as most good ideas come from TikTok. So I was out walking one day scrolling through TikTok when I came upon a quiz called the official ABB / ABG calculator, and my initial thought was like, wow, this is like such a good idea, and my second thought was maybe I can do something similar. I thought because the calculator was such a niche sort of demographics, it only related to people in Australia. I wanted to target a bigger demographics, and I thought what would be better than a whole race. So, and it was a topic that I was able to relate to and knew quite a lot about. So I used that as the idea. I do want to preface that the quiz was based on my own experiences, so it is not a portrayal of the whole race. At this point, I knew the idea that I wanted to implement, and I had a vision of what it would look like, just because I had recently started learning web development, so basic HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. And I knew there was a quiz called the Rice Purity Test, which I wanted to leverage just based on how simple it looked. And so I coded up the quiz in a few days, and I rushed it a bit just because I thought someone else would have a similar idea. I don't know why I had the idea, but I thought that the idea would get stolen. So after I finished coding up the quiz, I just needed a medium to sort of get people to use the quiz and share it with their friends. And at that time, there was a Facebook group called the Subtle Asian Traits, which was popping off at the time. And I knew that if I could get my quiz posted on that, then it would start spreading and people would start sharing it and using it, and the cycle would continue. So a few days later, I typed up a post and posted the quiz on Subtle Asian Traits. And once it got posted, it started getting a lot of traction pretty quickly. People started using the test and tagging their friends, and slowly a lot of people saw the quiz and it spread like wildfire. I implemented Google Analytics just to see how many people were using my website, and the numbers got pretty crazy as soon as the quiz was posted. I tried to record how many people were on the website whilst I was asleep, because I knew that the US would be awake while I was sleeping, and I wanted to see how crazy the numbers would get, but I don't think it worked that well because my laptop ran out of storage. So the next day when I checked, there were so many people who had used the website, and from there I kept getting notifications that people were commenting on the post, and the number of people on Google Analytics just kept growing. I've come out with my experiences with three key takeaways and sort of three repeatable frameworks that if you follow, then you should be able to replicate my results. The first one is find a niche that you know a lot about. I think a large part of the success of my website was being able to relate to a lot of people with similar experiences and finding inside jokes that a lot of people would get. The second point is, if you are going for virality, then think of a medium that would be easily shared. So for me, this was a quiz. The third point I would say is, know where you can easily get eyes on your projects, and know somewhere where a lot of people can find out about your project. So this could just be social media with a lot of people in that group. And once it starts getting eyes on it, then it's likely to spread just based on word of mouth and people tagging or sharing your project. So the second section is results, which is my favorite part because of just how crazy the numbers are. So in total, since I first launched the website, the total number of users that visited my website was 576,135 users. It's also actively being used with spikes and dips throughout the week, with around 300 people using the quiz. I might make another video on how much I made from the website, so let me know if you want to know that as well. And the last section is future plans with the website. So over the past 3 years, I didn't really have any idea of what I wanted to do with the website. I thought of making sort of this video just to wrap up the whole experience. But recently I got the idea to sort of clean up the code base and maybe make more quizzes similar to the current quiz, just because I'm like itching to work on something on the side apart from my job. And I feel like given the success of this current website, if I follow the framework and create similar websites, then it will also get this amount of success. But yeah, please let me know if this is something you would want to see, and maybe I will video it and bring you guys along on the journey as well. But yeah, I think that was all I wanted to share for this video. I hope you guys are having a lovely start to 2023, and I'll see you in the next one.